In just 1 month, the long-awaited Javan Bay Hospital Riverside will open its doors.
More than 3 years and $500 million have gone into the project. A ribbon cutting and dedication ceremony were held today. Jerrica Valtierra was there.
Eric and Emily, that's right. When projects like this come to a region, new employees and their money come with it. That's why Mercyhealth and Rockford leaders believe the opening of this hospital will be a boom for the economy.
When you have an investment like this, and it draws that many people than it does to our community, and in particular patients from outside the area, there's a lot of spillover effect that has. Those patients, those doctors, they shop in our stores, they need housing.
It's now been 6 months since the doors opened on the largest construction project in Rockford history. In tonight's iTeam report, Prescription for Success, Mike Garrigan looks at how Mercyhealth, Javan Bay Hospital, Riverside, and local businesses have been impacted by this historic expansion, as well as the potential future benefits to not only the east side, but all of Rockford.
We've hired over 250 new physicians and created 735 new healthcare jobs, nurses, therapists, techs, etc.
And while current shops and restaurants along Riverside and Perryville have already seen a positive economic impact, Loves Park Mayor Greg Jury tells me the sky's the limit when it comes to construction near the Riverside campus.
There's 600 acres up there of shovel-ready lots. I mean, so for the next couple years, I expect our community development and building department to be really, really busy.
Dickerson and Neiman Realtors President Frank Wurstein says it's not just doctors buying homes that will give the local market a pricing boost, but rather all the jobs that go along with the new development spearheaded by the new hospital.
The jobs, that's what we need. That will help stimulate and drive prices up in our marketplace.
A lot of the Mercyhealth revenue is new to the area. In fact, Bay says they originally projected $30 million a year in Wisconsin patient revenue, but they now see bringing in more than $100 million a year from Wisconsin patients.
Mercyhealth, in partnership with Crusader Community Health, helped formulate a plan to meet the region's need for the highest level neonatal intensive care with its state-of-the-art 52-bed NICU and services for high-risk moms.
It was a special day at Mercyhealth's Javan Bay Riverside campus today as neonatal intensive care staff hosted a reunion with the graduates and their families.
The hospital receives a prestigious designation. The certification reflects the highest level of competence for treatment of patients who've experienced a serious stroke.
Mercyhealth is now certified as a comprehensive stroke center, the highest level of stroke certification in the country.
Meantime, a new device that removes life-threatening blood clots from the brain is being used at Mercyhealth.
Mercyhealth opened its $5 million orthopedic institute on Wednesday with newly recruited adult and pediatric surgeons ready to accommodate the area's growing need for exceptional orthopedic care.
Mercyhealth is going to new heights, announcing they will start construction on a new helipad at its Rockton Avenue campus. Doctors unveiled their new TrueBeam Linear Accelerator today inside Mercyhealth's expanded cancer center. It's part of the hospital's $7 million investment into its new cancer wing.
Mercyhealth Javan Bay Hospital Rockton campus nearly had to shut down due to massive flooding last June, and now they're out to make sure they're never in that situation again.
Dorsey wants to make clear that Mercyhealth's West Side campus isn't going anywhere.
And we're looking at about 1 million patient visits to this campus every year, and we do not intend in any way, shape, or form to walk away from that commitment.
The health system is set to spend millions more to continue to upgrade the campus. Hospital leadership says the renovations include water remediation work, a modernized surgical prep and recovery area, a makeover to its ICU and medical surgical units, a newer, modernized look to the majority of the hospital's private rooms, nurses' stations, hallways, and more. This new multi-million dollar investment puts Mercyhealth on track to outpace its original promise to invest $50 million on the Westside campus over 10 years. That was the promise in 2015 when the merger happened. And it's looking like Mercyhealth will surpass that promise to the community in half the time the hospital leaders said they would. Why? They say it's to provide patients the best possible care no matter where they live in Rockford. Rockton, Riverside, clinics and urgent care, Mercyhealth is unrivaled in its nearly $1 billion investment in the community, and it's having a ripple effect in the local economy, transforming lives and people's expectations of what their healthcare provider should offer them when it matters most.